class of editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding the multiple costs of death penalty written by R.K. Raghavan. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2, plus this is very very important for political science optional students. Now what is this editorial about? This editorial is about, is death penalty an effective deterrent or not? This editorial is also about, should we sustain with the death penalty or not? This editorial is also about the comparative analysis between what is happening in United States of America and accordingly what action should the government of India be taking. This editorial is about the recent discourse dialectics in the domain of death penalty. Now in order to understand this death penalty, we really need to know about why a punishment is generally given in adjudication. Now the judiciary will decide about your case, it will be looking for the pros and the cons against an alleged person, and accordingly it will be deciding should the person be given punishment or he should be just left free. Now as far as the death penalty is concerned, it is the highest form of the punishment. Now if you look at the penology, the basic purpose of the penology is either to reform a person or to be retributive towards him or to give a punishment in order to set up a standard so that it can act as a deterrent for the future motivators to commit such a crime. So there are three aspects why a punishment is given: either to make the people deterrent, either to demotivate the people, either to set up an example that the person who is willing to commit such a crime may not end up committing such a crime by looking at the punishments given to the people in the past. Now, when it comes to death penalty, it has not acted as an effective deterrent. अभी डेथ पेनाल्टी से ऐसा नहीं है कि किसी को डेथ पेनाल्टी दे दिया है उसके बाद में वो पर्टिकुलर क्राइम होना बंद हो गया है. किसी ने बहुत ब्रूटल रेप किया है और उस ब्रूटल रेप में उस आदमी को हमने डेथ पेनाल्टी दिया है, सुसाइड बहुत ज्यादा एडवर्टाइज भी किया है, लोगों को पता भी चला, उसके बाद में फिर ब्रूटल रेप्स होते हैं. किसी ने बहुत ब्रूटल ढंग से किसी को मार दिया है, ऑनर किलिंग कर दिया है, उनकी फैमिली को प्रोसिक्यूट कर दिया, एग्जीक्यूट करने के ऑर्डर्स है, उनको डेथ देने के ऑर्डर्स है, बट स्टिल व्हाट यू विल सी दैट देयर विल स्टिल बी अ प्रेवेलेंस ऑफ सच टाइप ऑफ क्राइम्स. सो देयर इज नो डायरेक्ट कोरिलेशन बिटवीन द डेटरेंसी ऑफ द डेथ पेनालिटी and the crime not taking place. Still the crime is taking place and that particular type of crimes are repeated again and again and again. So one logic to keep this death penalty on the basis of deterrency is actually a farce, is fluke, it does not hold a lot of logic. So the second thing, that the punishment should provide a chance for any aberrant person to come on the line, because every saint has a past, and this is a very good analysis, this is a very good logic behind that the judiciary must provide the reformative chance to the persons who have aberrated from the right course. Now when the saints, they had their past, they had done something wrong, but they have reformed themselves. Now the person who committed a brutal crime or something of that sort, he or she also should be given an opportunity to join the mainstream of the society. But when it comes to a very brutal crimes, rarest of the rarest crimes, such an excuse cannot be taken by the judiciary. Judiciary cannot take such a chance to let that person go, because that person can unleash lot of terror, lot of misery and lot of agony on the people. Because if somebody who has committed a crime, he is also psychologically disturbed, and and he or she has an inclination. This is done by a study on the criminals in Australia. They develop a kind of a distinct bent of mind to commit a crime again and again. And this is the justification on why the people should be executed. But on the other hand, the judiciary also holds the responsibility to reform a person. Now the death penalty, it offers no choice. So there is a logic that the death penalty should be converted to lifelong imprisonment. Lifelong means lifelong. Now for that, in case of India, what we will need to do? We will need to amend the laws. We will need to amend the CRPC, Criminal Procedure Code. Because this Criminal Procedure Code in India allows the executive to let the prisoner go after 14 years of imprisonment. Now anybody who has been in the jail and has been awarded the life term imprisonment or double life term imprisonment, regress life term imprisonment, he or she gets entitled to a waiver by the executive after 14 years. So ipso facto it will never happen. He or she has to get it done from the government, from the executive. But generally the kind of the trend that we see, the government leaves the people who have been in jail for about 14 years, irrespective of the crime that they had committed or they had not committed. Now this has been the cause of the concern of the judiciary, and the judiciary has passed directions to the government of India and to the president and to the various governors of the state that they should not be using this provision of pardoning casually. They should look into the specificities of the case before deciding about whether a person should be left or should not be left. Now the third provision is judiciary right in retributing about the crimes that has been committed by the humans. Now if we look at the type of the crimes committed, there are crimes that are committed against the state, there are crimes that are committed against the relatives, there are crimes that are committed against the members of the society. Now when the crimes, terrorist crimes, are committed against the society and it leads to the death of any number of person, then the justification of death penalty exists. But according to Law Commission, this year's report on death penalty, Law Commission says that there is no justification or a solid justification to award a death penalty if a person has committed a crime like rape or a murder or a dacoity. Because such type of crimes, a person may not have been able to defend himself. Because this is how the entire adjudication process operates in India. You need a lot of money, you need a lot of logic, you need a lot of strength to fight your case. And generally, if a person is not willing to defend himself despite being innocent, he or she will still see the gallows. And in order to save him from the gallows, it is important that we must not be using this death penalty on a casual and regular basis. This should be a rarity. And this is already a standard in India. We use the death penalty in the rarest of the rarest cases. But rarest of the rarest cases is a subjective term, and it is generally defined by the courts. Generally by the Supreme Court. Supreme Court has decoded this term in n number of cases. But in the recent cases, in the Nitish Katara case, the Supreme Court has said that this case does not fall in the category of the rarest of the rarest crime. And accordingly, they cannot award a death penalty to the culprits. Now, when you look at the case of the United States of America, the condition is entirely different. In some of the states, the death penalty has been abolished. And there are ways by which the death penalty is conferred to a person, by hanging, by giving him a lethal injection, and or by electrocuting. Different ways, the debates are still going on, but they have moved on from electrocuting a person to hanging him, now to giving him a lethal drug. So this was all for the tutorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is EIS Mentors. You can contact me at 845-940-000 in case you are interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. And to view the information of the classes, please visit our website eiasmentors.com and brainiki.com. And we are just about to refurbish brainiki.com. You will be able to upload answers by your phone, by your tablet, and you will get any number of other things. You can join the debates, you can join the discussions, you can post your queries, you will get questions answers not only from me but from the other people, aspirants who are preparing. So it will be a kind of a quite interactive website that we have designed. So it will be uploaded in a day or two, still working on it. So please install our application. Name of the application is Brainiki. You can find the application from Google Play Store and from App Store, and do keep writing these answers that we post in Brainiki.com. I may not get the time to evaluate each and every answer, but still, whenever I will get it, because till 16th, I am very busy. After that, I will evaluate all the answers. And if you have liked this video, do click on the like button, do share and comment on this video. Bye bye, take care. Have a nice day.